Another day in Muscle Car Madness Garage. So we're on to the next two things here. Exhaust and universal joint. So another technical day, we're moving forward. Come on, let's go to the garage. First thing is right here, this universal joint won't raise up in here. I think I already know the reason why. And it was because the transmission, when I was pulling the engine out, the transmission was dipping down, and that caused the drive shaft to fall out. So that's what we're doing right now. Jeff is here wrenching away, and we're gonna either push up the transmission or bring it down, either one. Second thing is, we kind of figured out about the exhaust, which is the next thing. So we're going to experiment with using a butt clamp to put these two together. So the extension pipe here and the head, you know, the collector is gonna be one clamp, which is gonna be this one right here. And then we're thinking about doing, this is a lap, which I did, because I cannot have a product on my car with that right there. That's not gonna happen. So I'm gonna get another one, which is a butt clamp, and me and Jeff are going to experiment whether or not we're gonna do the butt clamp, which is the same size as that, or we're gonna do something like this right here, this. So we're gonna do one or two of those within the next, you know, this week. And my hope is that by the end of this week, we will be finished with putting on the drive shaft. We'll be done with the drive shaft. And then we'll also be finished with the exhaust. After that, I think after that it's just gonna be the small details on the engine, getting the interior, the dash finally, you know, finished, and then we'll be on to paint and body. So anyway, let me go ahead and see what I can do for Jeff, and then we'll hopefully get this drive shaft back up in there. Welcome back to Muscle Car Madness Garage. Got a very interesting day here today. Barrett Jackson sent me two media passes. Meekum turned me down. So it looks like I'm heading to Scottsdale at the end of January. Come on, let me give you an update of what's going on in the garage. Got a few parts that have come in as well. I'm gonna show you those in just a second. And then also, I have tried everywhere and looked and made several phone calls to somebody, any company that could help me re-chrome this cover here. Because you can't buy one brand new. They don't make them anymore. You see how rusty this thing is. And so I'm starting to do the work now on the cover here, which the inside has turned out very well. And so I just, you know, did a light sand on this part here. And that is also looking very good. So I could not get all the rust off of the lid. I tried everything, the aluminum, the Coca-Cola, all those things wouldn't work. So I'm just gonna take some sandpaper and sand it down. And then I bought this paint right here, this chrome paint, and I'm going to test out whether or not that can work on this. I'm thinking it can. So anyway, that's what's gonna happen with it. All right, then secondly, I got some parts in for the pipes. Do you remember me telling you about the, you know, those connections, right? So they were the lap, you know? These are the butt. So let me go open them up. I'll show you what they look like. Then we can test out which ones I'm gonna use. So here is that butt joint here, clamp. This goes onto that right there. And once that's tight, that, since the pipes are the same size, and that should clamp that up pretty good. That's what it looks like there. Yeah, that'll look good. And then the other one is came with the pipe. You know, it came with this pipe here. And it'll go over the header. Yep. And that's what that looks like. So I think that with this now, I think we can say that the exhaust is finished. So I'm going to work on that transmission right now, try to get it back up into place. And got it currently on some jacks now because the transmission is way up in the air. That's how we was able to get the universal joint into place. And so, you know, actually worked out for the best because those caps were actually missing some bearings. So we took, you know, we took some of them bearings out and put it into the old cap, put that in there. And so now I feel a lot safer, a lot better. In fact, using the new cap there, or the new, you know, bearings in the old cap, just snap right back on there. So we'll start working on that now, see if we can get that, see if we can get the transmission back in place. Okay, so I got a chain around our homemade engine lift, and of course our new employee here, which is just paid for itself already. So I got that back underneath there, and the drive shaft, as you can see, is in place. Let me show that to you. Yeah, drive shaft is in place like so. Oh yeah, real nice. Yeah, didn't have to replace the entire joint, but did put new bearings into those caps. Now I gotta clean it up, paint it, and it'll be just fine. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is, there's the brace there. I'm gonna put the brace back on and then secure the transmission, and that's gonna do it. And then I'm gonna start working on this exhaust now that we've got it pretty much in place. All right, y'all, that's it. Transmission back in place. And I tell you, the only thing that kind of concerns me is that the brace is rubbing on that linkage right there. I don't know if that's gonna mean anything in the future or what. We're gonna have to keep an eye on that right there. But other than that, I am super pleased with this whole thing here. I mean, this was the drive shaft that popped out on me. I don't know if y'all remember that, but I made a video of that. And then all the way in the back there, and since the car's in neutral, it's rolling along just fine. I gotta clean it up now, but I sure am glad I painted it. I got that paint under there. Okay, now I'm gonna start experimenting now with the exhaust. And since I've got the pipes in, may start experimenting with that and at least getting them. I got this material that I was told to use right here. So I'm gonna read on how to use it and then go about trying to put these pipes on. All right, so here we go. Okay, let me show you what I'm looking at here. So I had to move this pipe way over, right? Because as you can see, they don't line up. You see that how far it's off here. This pipe just moving in the wrong direction, even though I don't have it in the muffler back there, but when you do put it in the muffler, it goes in the wrong, you know, basically it's moving in the wrong direction. Let me show you what I'm talking about real quick. So when I put it in the muffler and then turn it towards the collector here, it doesn't line up. it's not lined up just right. So I had to move the pipe over. And then when I moved it over, it had a gap above it. Let me show you real quick. You see what I'm saying? So there's a, it doesn't line up just right. So what I may end up doing is using one of these things right here. You know, it just goes in and closes up that gap a little bit, like right up in there. And then it's possible that I could go back and use this lap or this butt clamp, or I could go and use a larger butt to ride up on there like that. So let me study this for a few minutes and I'll get back with you in just a couple minutes. Okay, we found the solution, and at least for the bracketing, I found the solution. So I only needed one of these connectors here is all I needed. Okay, and so we're gonna go over this one, which it fits real, real snug on this one, all right? This is gonna go in that pipe right there, boom. That's a pretty good fit. I mean, it's not exact perfect, but it's pretty good. And then I'll just put some clamps, two clamps on that right there, one and two. And simply because the butt clamp going over it, you would have some exhaust leak. So just two regular clamps. Then on this side over here, there's a real nice clamp that came with that, you know, this pipe. And it fits over this perfectly. I mean, it's just like, boom. That's perfect right there. And that clamp will go right there. Now, what I'm gonna have to do is I'll cut it to size somewhere in there, and then I'll rotate, you know, have to rotate it a little bit, and then just push them in, you know, just push them in. And I was able to rotate this one a little bit. Yeah, so as you can see how it maybe able to see it, it rotates up. So once it rotates up, this pipe moves in, and then it should be okay. Should be okay, yeah. All right, so I only had one of the connectors. So I gotta, you know, I actually got it at AutoZone. So I'll have to go back over there and grab one, and then, you know, we'll see how I feel at that point. So there it is right there. Exhaust pieces, just missing one little thing, and I'm all set. Okay, so I got the solution. So I need one more of these right here, and I need one more of those. I need two clamps, one size bigger than that. And that's it. And then I'm gonna get something that go on the tailpipe, is sort of taps up against the body underneath the back there. So I get a little something to wrap it with right there so it doesn't make any noise. But now if I can get this piece tonight, I finish this thing tomorrow, wrap it up. And I think that's it, y'all. So anyway, great day here in the garage. Great day at Musclecar Madness Garage overall. Great week, in fact. So after this exhaust is done, which hopefully will be tomorrow, then I'm going to actively start working on the paint and body. So my mother bought me a real nice paint gun. I've got a thing I bought at my favorite store tonight, Catch the Vapor. And I think I got all the sandpaper I need. I certainly got the machine to do it, that's for sure. You saw that thing last time, hopefully. And so the manager of the garage hopefully will be over tomorrow, help me clean up the yard and get my paint booth set up. After that, I was told I needed some heat to go in there, these heat stands, right? So I may buy myself a Christmas present on that. And then I'm going to experiment with painting the hood of my truck and, you know, get me some experience painting. And then I'm gonna start with those doors, right? Learning how to do fiberglass or whatever. I mean, that's what's gonna happen. And then from there, I'll move on to the fenders. You know, the spoiler is around here somewhere, and the trunk. And then, you know what's left. After that will be the regular body. And then once we get all that finished, then we'll do the interior, the finish up the interior, which is the headliner, and weld in the back seat, because, you know, you saw the seats are all done. Put the carpet in, do all the little small stuff. So anyway, I mean, I'm just putting it in my head now. My thinking is, I don't know, end of February, by that time, that 289 motor will be finished. And then we'll just move on to that. And hopefully that won't be more than 3-4 months on a build on that. I don't have another car after that, y'all. I'll be looking for another car after that. So anyway, I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas. I'm sure I'll see you before then, but just in case you skip a video or whatever, I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas and a good New Year. Apparently, I'm heading to Barrett Jackson, so I'll be there for a week. Might go live. I'll be doing a lot of recording, that's for sure. So anyway, I'll see you fellas next time, and Mama, at the fantastic Muscle Car Madness Garage. I think we're on to something. Boom.